regarding CBSE registration form. So please send it to me as soon as possible. I've only received 7 or 8.
Ma'am, I have sent it, ma'am.
Yes, Ayan, I received yours. Other students also, please send it to me by today or maximum tomorrow. Okay, it is very important. And please keep it in mind that it should be less than 35 KB. Not more than that. Okay? There are particular specifications that comes, okay, from the officials that it should be less than 35 KB only. Okay? And rename your file with your name. It will be very easy for me. Some I have received as screenshot or something like this. So just rename it in your name and then send it to me. Is that clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I hope there's no doubt. So today we start with a new chapter, the Albert Einstein chapter from the other book. Okay, we start with that. So first of all, we study one quote by Albert Einstein himself. So the quote goes like, education is what remains. Education is what remains after one has forgotten what one has learned in school. Okay? So the quote is, I'll repeat it again. Please write it down, everyone. This is a very important quote. Please write it down, everyone. The quote is, education is what remains. Write it down. Education is what remains after one has forgotten. After one has forgotten what one has learned in school. After what one has learned in school. Written, or should I repeat one? Should I repeat or you have written?
Yes, ma'am. Please repeat it again.
Education is what remains. Education is what remains after one has forgotten. After one has forgotten. After one has forgotten what one has learned in school. Written? Written? Yes, no. Okay, now please take at least 2 to 3 minutes, okay? Write it down or just think about what this quote is trying to tell you. Take 2 to 3 minutes, understand the quote, and let's discuss what is this quote trying to tell us. This quote is by Albert Einstein. You can also write it down. That's always preferable. Okay, another minute. Think about the quote. Okay, yes. Now, tell me, what is this quote trying to tell you? Tell me. Okay.
Life is a lot of things, but the things which we remember are the things which we have actually learned or have actually failed them in our real life.
Okay, very good. So see, for example, if I ask you that, okay, class 10th was just a few months back, right? You're in class 11th right now. Class 10th was just a few months back. Okay, so if I ask you, do you remember what you learned in class 10th SST or history? What did you learn? Do you remember?
No, I don't.
Okay, you do, Kanak?
I don't know.
You don't
know. Basically what we studied in like different subjects.
Okay, so see, the thing is that if I ask you that what you, you know, what can you recall from class in history, you'll be able to give me the overview that, ma'am, we did Russian Revolution, or we did French Revolution, or we did nationalism in India. These are the things that we did. But if I ask you to go in more detail, if I ask you, do you remember the date? Do you remember the date of Russian Revolution when it started? You won't be able to tell me till the time you look up in the internet, right? You won't be able to tell me. Why is that? Why is that you don't remember anything? The thing is that you all feel like that. And it's very true. It's true with me also. We feel like that what we learned in school, that the purpose of learning was to just clear the examination. Right? For us, the purpose of learning was to just clear the examination. And once we cleared the examination, we came in class 11, we just forgot everything. Yeah?
It can be like it's not of relevance now. So like we don't need to remember.
Need to remember it, yeah. Second of all, but there are still some things that, for example, archaeologist, okay, or any kind of historian, okay, if I go and ask an historian, do you remember the date, why and when did this thing happen, he'll be able to tell me that, yes, I do remember the date, because he takes an interest in all of these things. Okay, now if you ask me personally, after I cleared out my class 12th, first of all, I did not have, in 11-12, I did not have math or I did not have science. Okay, I had commerce, but I did not have math because I never had an interest in math and science. And that's a very honest answer. Okay, so once I was done with math and science in class 10, I was so relieved. I was like, okay, that's it for me. I cannot do this further because I never took an interest in that. Okay, all I had an interest was in English literature since I was in grade 8. Okay, and if you ask me that what did I learn in grade 8 or 9, I will not remember a thing. But if you ask me what novels I read grade 8 and 9, I will able to tell you in a second. Okay, because that is where my interest was. Clear? Now, if I ask you, for example, let's take an example of one student. Okay, Jayant, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, if I ask you, what is your interest in? Which field?
Basically, I'm anything astrophysics or chemistry.
Astrophysics or chemistry. Let's just stick to the school level and let's say chemistry, for an example. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Now, what happens is that you go home, okay, and you learned a lot of things. You learned what was taught you in English. You learned what was taught in physics or math or chemistry. But one thing will surely be in your mind is what you learned in chemistry. The other thing,
yeah,
a big possibility that you will forget. The moment you go home from school or the moment the classes end, you will forget. Till the time you practice, obviously, you will forget. But it will stay in your mind that what was learned in chemistry or what Seema ma'am taught you, it will stick in your mind. Okay? And you might, yes, if this is a new thing that you learned in chemistry, you will look into that. Okay? You will look into that part. You will study on your own also. Okay, so where your interest lies matters a lot. Okay, so first of all, the first thing that matters is interest. And then the other thing that matters is practice. Now, when I say practice, is that if a teacher teaches you a formula, let's take math for example. If a teacher teaches you some formula and you do not practice it, you will forget it in 2 days. Okay, I am saying, but this is how the mind works. This is how the mind works. If you don't practice it, you will forget it. Okay. Should I tell you one interesting thing? Okay, listen to this. This is a very interesting thing. Okay, understand this. It's a new thing and it's a very interesting thing. And, you know, let's just keep studies aside. In our brain, we have sections in our brain. Okay. We have frontal lobe. We have amygdala. Let's not go into the technical side. But the front part of the brain, okay, the front part of the brain is called as frontal lobe. Okay. Are you with me till now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Interesting thing. Okay, just listen. It's a very interesting thing. It will stay with you. So the front part of your brain is called a frontal lobe. In that lobe, in that part of the brain, there is one thing called as working memory. It's called as working memory. Now that part of the brain is like a table. Okay, that part of the brain is like a table. Now on the table, you can only keep 2 to 3 things. Or more than that, if the table is huge, more than that, right? But just imagine there's a very small table and you can only keep 2 to 3 things. Okay, if you keep a 4th thing on the table, one thing will definitely fall out of the table. Yeah, clear? So same way is our brain, same way is that part, the front part of the brain. This states that if I say that the front part of the brain is like a table, I say it because at a particular time, at a particular moment, you can only keep 2 to 3 things or maximum 4 things in your mind. The frontal lobe, only 4 things. All of the things that you know, all of the things that you have known in your life stays in the back of your mind. For example, as I said, right now you can only think of 3 things. Okay. So first thing that you must be thinking is that what I am teaching you. One thing will be this. Other than that, you can only think of 2 things. You can try it at home also. Okay. It will be kind of an experiment for you all. Okay. So at a point of time, you can only keep 3 things in your mind. Now, if I ask you that, okay, Kanak, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Kanak, if I ask you that, recite ABCD for me, do you have to think about that or you'll just start reciting?
I'll just start reciting.
Start reciting. Okay, so what happens is that ABCD, that alphabet, are always at the back of your mind. You're not thinking it right now. You're not thinking it right now. Till the time I ask you, it stays back in the mind. when I asked you that recite ABCD, that alphabet came from the back of your mind to the front table that I'm talking about. And one of the things that was on the table goes back in the mind. Clear? Now this is a very interesting theory. Now, there was one question that when I was learning this theory, when I was in college and I learned this theory, one question I want to ask that, what if I wanted to expand my working memory? What if I wanted to expand the table? I want more things on the table. I can't just think of three things at a time. I want more things to think about. Yeah, reasonable question. The answer I got was to increase that working memory, to increase that area of the brain, you need to practice. Okay? So, when our teachers tell us, you know, go home and practice this question, go home and practice this topic, we take it very lightly. We are like, okay, we practice, ye hai, wo hai. We take it very lightly. But the thing with practice is, it is the utmost important thing to keep that thing in your mind. If I am practicing one thing on a regular basis, okay? If I am practicing one thing on a regular basis, that thing will automatically be on my, you know, working memory on the table forever. All the things that you remember till now is the result of your practice. The things that you learned just before the exam, or the things that you learned just for the purpose of clearing the exam, you have forgotten that. But the things that you have practiced a lot, if you don't, you won't remember, but when you were a child, when you were in the play school, and the teacher was teaching you ABCD, the teacher made you, learn that ABCD so many times. She made you sung that alphabet. Okay? And at a point of time, you were continuously repeating it. That's why it is still with you, because of practice.
Mom, also we have photographic memory, so that helps too.
Basically, what you see is what you remember. Some people who have photographic memory are those people who have good photographic memory. If I show them something, okay, if they see even the smallest of the detail, if I take that person to a monument or something, and that person sees that monument, and that person focuses on one particular detail, that will stay with him if he has good photographic memory.
Yes, ma'am.
Now you know the importance of practice also. Clear? It's a very interesting thing to know about. Did you understand it though?
Yes, ma'am. Yes. Basically, it's like a CPU in a living organism, because like the frontal memory is like basically.
And it's like we are refreshing ourselves, the memory, to keep it within our brain.
Can you repeat one by one, Jayant? What were you saying?
Well, I'm saying like basically it's like a working CPU inside a human, because like the frontal, like accessible memory is RAM, random accessible memory or cache, and the back memory is like a ROM, like walking and all. We don't think about it, right? Or
you very good. Yes, Kanak, you were saying?
It's like refreshing every time so that it doesn't go back in our memory. It's like refreshing.
Very good. It's like refreshing. Very good, Kanak. So it's like recalling everything so that it just stays there. It just stays in our working memory. Okay? So even though it goes back to your, you know, what happens is that it's a little bit darker side. A few months or for a few years, I am no one to judge on that. That person tends to remember every single detail about that person. But over the time, the person starts losing some memories of that person. okay, even though he still misses him or her, but that person starts losing some parts of memories of that person. Because in our daily life, we have so much on our working memory, always and always new things are added on the table. Always and always, you know, new things are added on the table. So some things automatically get pushed back. Okay, so that person, if he has lost a loved one, after a few years, he will be fine. He won't be into like the grief phase. He won't be into that, but he'll be fine. He'll be able to do those daily activities again. Until and unless someone comes and, you know, starts talking about the loved one, then that person will recall every single thing.
Like, place when we get to remind of the person like that too.
Yes. So it's basically the psychology of your brain. Okay. So if you really think about it, that this whole thing, the working memory, the frontal lobe thing, you know, this helps you keep some things fresh in mind. Okay, coming back to Albert Einstein. Now, so for him was the education that remains after you have gone home after school, and what sticks in your mind, what stays in your mind, that is when what he said is education. So education is basically knowledge. Okay, education is basically knowledge. To know. Okay, to know something, to have a knowledge, to have an understanding of a particular thing is education. So one thing is your interest or the practice. Second, how it helps you. How it helps you. Like when we were talking about the relevance of a particular thing, we talked about the dates in history are not relevant to us. Okay, it won't help us in real life, but it will help an archaeologist. Okay? So, the things that you learn, that you know will help you. For example, in your school, you form friendships, you form relationships. So, the things that your friendship teaches you, okay, the kind of company you keep, the kind of things that you learn from your friends, from your teachers, the conversations that you have, the rules that you followed in school that made you more disciplined. Okay? These are the things that will definitely stay with you. Okay? Because these are the things that help you develop a better personality. Okay? And that in turn helps you in real life. Is that clear? So education is also what you learn and how it helps you. Okay, now this quote is clear. Education is what remains after one has forgotten what one has learned in school.
Yes, ma'am.
Knowledge and education is different, but education is a part of knowledge. Education is a part of knowledge. Knowledge is a much broader sense. A person might know every single thing and he might not be educated. Okay? A person might be educated. A person might have all the, you know, good school facilities, good teachers, textbooks. He's well educated. But when it comes to testing his knowledge on other aspects, you know, that knowledge might be poor. Okay, so the knowledge is a much broader concept. Clear? Okay. Okay. Now, what do we know about Albert Einstein?
Mom, he was a physicist. Like, theoretical synthesis.
Okay, very good. Another one? Anyone else?
Mom, he had been like that. He had drastically in the evolution of the physics what we know of, like, and the basic understanding of the universe.
Okay. Okay, what was this theory that was very
breakthrough? Theory of relativity.
Theory of relativity. Okay, so we'll be talking about Albert Einstein on the basis of, first of all, I give you a brief introduction. Okay, then we'll talk about his early life. Okay, then we'll talk about his education. Then family life. Then his scientific work. Then Nazi targeting. Does anyone know what was about Nazi targeting him? Why did Nazi targeted him? Why did Hitler target him?
He was Jewish.
Yeah, he was Jewish. Very good. And then we'll just read 2-3 fun facts about him. Okay? Whatever I write down on the board about Albert Einstein, please note down in the register. Okay? So, we'll study about introduction, early life, education, family life, scientific work, Nazi targeting, and fun facts. Today, we'll read about introduction and early life. Okay, introduction. So who was Albert Einstein? He was a German mathematician and physicist. He was a German mathematician and physicist. Okay. Next, he was, so again, what was the theory that was very famous? Theory of?
Relativity.
Ma'am, general theory of relativity and specific theory of relativity.
Developed the theory of relativity. Okay. He also won a Nobel Prize. Winner of the Nobel Prize. Then he fled Nazi Germany to US. He fled Nazi Germany and went to US. Okay. Now, the four things that we have done, German mathematician and physicist, developed the theory of relativity, winner of the Nobel Prize, and he fled Nazi Germany to US. I want the years of this. When did he develop the theory of relativity? When did he win the Nobel Prize? And when did he fled Nazi Germany and went to US? Okay, so this is your homework also. Okay, get me the years to this. I'll just take a picture and I'll send it to it. Is that clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, early life. Okay. Early life. So he was born on March 14, 1879 in Germany. Okay. Next point, he was raised in a Jewish household. This we know that he was Jewish. Yeah? He was raised in a Jewish household. Any doubt up till now?
No, ma'am.
No.
Okay. Next, he had one elder sister.
He was born in Munich, right?
Yes, Munich, Germany. He had one elder sister.
Ma'am, okay. Younger sister.
Sure.
Yes, ma'am.
Let me see first. Just a second. Okay, this I need to confirm whether she was the younger sister or the elder sister.
I'm younger sister.
Coming up chapter in class 10th, we read that she was born after him.
Yes, ma'am.
So he had a reaction to
it. Yes, ma'am.
So he was born in 1879. Which year was she born in?
Ma'am, that wasn't mentioned, but ma'am, she was born after Albert.
And there's also a particular incident where he asked that where are its wheels, because Einstein assumed that it's a toy, not a newborn baby.
Yes, ma'am.
5-year-old and the only surviving letter. Maya. Maya is the name of the sister. Yeah, I guess she's a younger sister and her name is Maya. And she was born in 1881. Maya Einstein. Yeah, she's the youngest. I'm so sorry. My mistake. Thank you. Okay. So, younger sister. And her name was Maya. And she was born in 1881. Okay. Good. Very good. Thank you. Next, the father.
Mommy also had trouble speaking while growing up. He wasn't an early speaker.
So we have 2 points. One was that the father was engineer and mom was housewife, and he had problems with speech as a child. He had problems with speech as a child, and the father was engineer. And mother was housewife. Okay, now The years that you have to tell me is when did he develop the theory of relativity? Okay. When did he win the Nobel Prize? And when did he go to US? Is that clear? And this was about his early life. The next topic that we'll study about will be his education and the family life. Okay. This we'll do in the next class. Is that fine? Any doubt up till now?
No, ma'am.
Let me quickly take the attendance. Akansha?
Present, ma'am.
Arav Grewal?
Ma'am, Arav Grewal present.
Arav Sharma? Agnish?
Present, ma'am.
Aishwarya?
Present, ma'am.
Akshata? Aman?
Present, ma'am.
Anshika?
Present, ma'am.
Arumita?
Present, ma'am.
Aryan?
Present, ma'am.
Bhavya Bhadwaj?
Present, ma'am.
Ayush? Bhavya Mishra?
Present, ma'am.
Taman? Divansh? Dishita?
Present, ma'am.
Galaxy? Gautam Kakkar? Gautam Kumar?
Present, ma'am.
Himanshu?
Present, ma'am.
Jayant? Kanak?
Present, ma'am.
Kanha?
Present, ma'am.
Kunjal?
Present, ma'am.
Lakshay?
Present, ma'am.
Linoy? Manav?
Present, ma'am.
Pragya? Rishabh? Rohan? Sahil Bisht? Sahil Sharma? Sanket? Sayam? Shashwat? Shivansh? Shriya?
Present, ma'am.
Siddhant Sharma? So now in the next class, we'll continue reading about Albert Einstein. Okay? And please complete the poster, everyone. Okay, the road safety one, the students have not sent. Please send it to me. Okay. And second of all, the photograph. That is very, very important. Please send it to me by today. All of you.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am, and the unseen passage.
Sorry, Bhavya.
Ma'am, the unseen passage which you gave.
Unseen passage you have done, all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, let me discuss the answers. Yes. Just a second. Okay. Okay, first question. The rains are called after flowering plants because, first answer is?
It is believed that plants bring the rain.
Very good. Second, the rain is like a calendar for farmers because?
It tells them when to sow and when to harvest.
Okay, very good. People who live in cities don't like rain because?
It brings
mud and mud with it.
Okay. People pray asking the rain to retreat because?
The crops need the sun and heat to ripen.
Very good, very good. Next question answers. First one is? Answer.
The elders warned us to understand the rain in the Naga Hills because rain always does different things at different times. It tells us when to sow and when to harvest. It can be gentle or too hard, leaving the crop damaged.
Okay. Second answer.
Ma'am, it means the end of rain. Durga Puja means the end of rainy season to the farmers of Naga Hills.
Third. Anyone else have done? Be Bhavya. Anyone else has done?
Ma'am, may I?
Yes, Kanna, tell me.
Ma'am, Sezo refers to the week-long rains where clothes don't dry and fungus and mold are common to find, and when one can't see the moon because of the rainy clouds.
Very good. Fourth. Kanna, fourth.
Ma'am, about 70% of the population is engaged in farming.
Okay. Fifth, Bhavya.
Ma'am, this 80% dislikes the rain because of landslides, muddy streets, and periodic infection. He finds rain depressing. However, farmer remains grateful for the rainy days.
Okay, very good. Sixth,
When the cycle of monsoon comes to an end, the earth turns hard quite quickly, and the rain becomes a distant memory to Naga people.
Very good. Now, seventh, first, Bhavya.
Blossoming.
Second, Kanak.
Ma'am, couldn't find it.
Ma'am, I think it's incessant something.
It's incessant. Answer is incessant. It must be in the paragraph itself. Sometimes there is a typo that it's written paragraph 7.
Yes, ma'am. The paragraph was interchanged. That's why I thought.
Yeah, you can find it in another paragraph. That's okay. The word remains the same. Okay, very good. Okay, I'll send at least one unseen para every week. Okay, so I'm expecting all of the students to do it. Is that fine?
But
Yes, ma'am.
I'll see you in the next class. Take care. Bye. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.